little antenna. There's a crank feature. Turn it on. 60.
Thursday, sunny. Highs in the upper 80s.
I love this radio. Absolutely love this radio.
Lows in the lower 60.
It's an emergency crank radio. You never have to worry about getting additional batteries. It has an antenna, has a solar panel. You leave it out in the sun and get some energy, get it working that way. Of course, the crank has been pretty reliable. I've had it for a couple years. I remember doing the original video. I've left it in the vehicle and under extreme cold conditions and extremely hot conditions, and it's still working pretty well. Flashlight, as you can see in the front, button up at the top of it. It has AM, FM, and of course, the most important for me, the weather band, the weather station. That's really, really important. It also has a port, a USB port for charging your cell phone, so that could be an option. You'll be cranking a lot, but hey, you know, at least you'll have some type of option. Let me make sure it's off. That is one of the downsides to this. You know, it has like a little green button that indicates that it's on. But you turn it all the way off, make sure it's off, you're not using any energy. But you don't have to crank it up that much for it to actually work for a while. So there's a little bit of cranking, maybe like 20 seconds or so, and it'll run for maybe 5 minutes or longer. It's just pretty easy to work with, so it's a good thing to have around, you know. So today I want to talk about prep items and emergency prep items and everyday items that I bought that I've used, especially on a regular basis, and how they held up, which items held up and which items didn't, and how long did they hold up. Welcome to the Dimcat channel. Alright, I was sort of inspired to do this video after something that I always depended on but never really thought about actually broke. This little keychain, this wallet chain, this little mechanism right here broke. I broke it today. I've been using it for such a long time. I actually bought this wallet right here in Kentucky, and it's something. I'm gonna get another one for sure. I'm definitely gonna get another one because I love this thing. It lasts a long time. I use it every day. That's the thing. And eventually, I broke it down. But I'm still satisfied with how long it lasts. This right here is a new device. Well, a new thing I bought is a replacement for my original. It's called the Rescue Q, the letter Q, Rescue Me. You put this on your keychain. It has a little black part that comes with it, and it snaps onto your keychain. You can use this blade right here to cut your seatbelt in case there's an accident, and press this up against glass if you want to break a window in case there's an accident, some type of emergency. Antelope, these batteries, man. I've recharged these things, I know, hundreds of times, and they work. These are the best rechargeable batteries I've ever used. This stuff has worked beautifully. You know, you can save a lot of money by just getting stuff like that and not buying batteries over and over again. The Leatherman Wave, this is something that I got maybe a couple years ago. But I've used this a lot more than I thought I would. And this is just a good everyday use item. It has a little saw on there, used for cutting knives. Of course, you can't bring this into a courthouse or anything like that. You know, that's an issue, but you know, there's a little file there. And you open it up and you have screwdrivers and pliers and all that stuff. Such a useful item. And my only complaint is that I wish the screwdriver bit was a little thinner. Let me open this up. I'll show you what I mean. It's sort of awkward trying to use it for certain projects. You know, it's wide. It's wide. It's really awkward trying to. The issue is it's hard to get to certain items. But anyway, I still use this. This is an everyday carry item. I put the chain right through here, and I have it with me every day. Another everyday carry item is this Phoenix flashlight, the LD22. I bought this 2 years ago, did a video on it. They have a new version, which I ordered. I'll see how that matches up. But I love the metal. It's probably aircraft grade aluminum. It's held up. I don't use the belt clip. I should probably get rid of that. But there has been some occasions where I accidentally turned on the light. It has multiple settings. I think it's like 200 and something lumens on the highest setting. It has a low, it has a SOS setting, a strobe. SOS setting, and the strobe setting as well. The newer ones are supposed to be 300 lumens, so we'll see how well that works out. But I've had this for 2 years, and you can tell I obviously use it, just like my all my other stuff. You know, certain items I carry every day, my Glock 21, you can look at it and you can tell that, hey, you know, I've used it for many, many different projects. You know, it's not something that just sits in a safe or whatever. But anyway, here's some new things I picked up. This is sort of an old school item, or at least I thought it was. This is something that people used to use a long time ago, or they use it now. I mean, it's supposed to be grandpa's coffee mug or whatever. That's what's used in the advertising, but it's from Stanley, of course, since 1913. It seems to be a pretty sturdy product. It's actually a vacuum. It's set up so that you can actually use the top as a cup. And you just open it up and you just pour your cold water in there, or ice water in there. It's supposed to keep the ice water or cold liquid products cold for over 100 hours or so. What is it, 120 hours? I haven't tried that out, but I will say this, that's the ice items. The ice items for 120 hours. The cold items for 24 hours, the hot items for 24. I've only used the cold items. I gotta tell you that, you know, even in a hot trailer, it works, because, you know, the metal that the water is getting in contact with, or whatever the cold substance is getting in contact with, whether it be, you know, juice or whatever, it's not the same metal that you're touching on the outside. It's a barrier there. It's, whether it be air, it's just, it's a great idea. I was just thinking about this the other day. Like, when if somebody needed this for a health reason, when somebody had some health issues and the grid went down and they wanted to find a way to keep their medicines cool or something, maybe like a diabetic or something, like, I wonder if they can just use this as sort of like a mini fridge or something for at least a short period of time to give themselves some options until they're able to find a better option. Just, you know, sort of drop your meds in here and some ice and some stuff like that if you think you're gonna have an issue for a long period of time. But this is sort of like my mug, my drinking mug. But, you know, you can use it for soup or whatever. Just heat up the food and keep it in there. It stays warm for a while. It can be a nice little morale booster if things do go south and you're relying on, you know, some emergency foods and you find a way to heat it up. Maybe you're using an MRE and those MREs come with little heaters. All you gotta do is just add a little water to it. Some of those MREs actually have little packages of salt water with them. But anyway, you can actually warm the food up. And if you want to keep it for later on, you can actually put the food in here. And this same type of product, but made by thermals. These thermals actually keep the product cold or keep the product hot. So it's a little interesting. I love these things. Yes, I even use this. I'm using this on the regular. This is kind of bizarre, but I love it. Yeah, another thing that's held up, the Serpa holster. Man, I've done everything with this thing. I don't just carry it every day. I carry this everywhere I go. You know, it's I've done everything from throwing garbage and crap out in the landfills to cleaning out houses to special projects with Nick when I was in Michigan to, you know, working on vehicles with Nick when I was in Michigan to hiking through the woods of various wooded areas in Kentucky to rolling around in the snow in Michigan, you know, all over. You know, if I had to move something heavy, I was carrying this thing, banging up against walls and whatever. I always had this rig set up, and it's worked. I haven't had any issue. Although you definitely need Loctite for these screws, or else, you know, the mechanism could cause this belt holder could cause the holster to fall off if it's not secured with Loctite or something like it. You can use nail polish as a substitute, but, you know, that lasts for about a year for me. But you need something like Loctite to really keep it in place. But yeah, I haven't had any issues with it. Some items that didn't really work out too well: cheap flashlights. And now let's talk about the stuff that did quite hold up. The cheap flashlights and ones under $20. Bad investment. You're better off buying a quality flashlight at $45 with a aircraft grade aluminum that actually lasts for a while than going with some cheap $20 flashlight that's going to fall apart after 6 months. Then you got to buy another one, and eventually you end up buying a better flashlight anyway. So I don't think people should go crazy and buy a $300 flashlight, but you definitely don't want to buy the really cheap stuff, because that stuff doesn't really hold up. Anyway, guys, thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. Share your thoughts on some prep items or some emergency items that actually held up. Stood the test of time. And share your comments below. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. Bye.